Reporting the mixed ANOVA will give you three possible scenarios. Scenario 1. In case none of your effects is significant, you will simply report that. Provide the test statistic alongside the degrees of freedom as well as the p-value. Scenario 2. In case you have a significant interaction of your between subject effect and within subject effect, you will report this and only this. Depending on if you calculated estimated marginal means for a significant interaction effect, you can add mean and SD for comparisons that showed pairwise differences. Be aware though that some reviewers will still insist on main effects being reported despite them being rendered kind of useless when the interaction effect turned out to be significant. Scenario 3. In case your interaction effect is not significant, you will report main effects regardless of significance or not. Additionally, you will also report the non-significance of the interaction effect. For any effect you decide to report, you are required to provide the test statistic alongside the degrees of freedom as well as the p-value. The effect size, usually eta squared, should also be reported and classified, with, for example, Cohen 92 or the respective research field-specific thresholds.